tweet has been sent.
Excellent.
Hello.
Shut down things. Hello, peoples.
And non-peoples, we don't discriminate.
So I've managed to re-raise a replacement Seaman. It's roughly where we were before. Oh, I think I may have started it. So we might have Leonard Nimoy in our microphone soon. Headphones, whatever. So yeah, I think we're a little bit, like, we're sort of in a slightly different state because I raised this Seaman a lot happier than the last one.
Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. This is your fourth visit today. You visit often. If one didn't know better, one might assume you're quite obsessed, or you have nothing better to do.
Ouch.
At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gillmen. They are enjoying a comfortable environment. Please continue your good work watching after them. Allow me to give you the highlights for today. Would you like to give Seaman a name? Call one of the gillmen and try saying, I will give you a name. So let us head over to the tank.
The current Seaman is still definitely a fratricidal sociopath.
Yeah.
That doesn't change.
I just tickled the Seaman a lot more. That's the main difference.
Okay, that's fucked up. And also, as always, please let us know if the audio is...
at a good level. So yeah, we've got 2 left, which is what we need to have a breeding pair, which is where we went wrong last time. We'll make sure both of these live. So yeah, here's how you tickle them. You just sort of like tap the grab button.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop
it.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
There we go. Sorry about that.
Seaman is bigger now. Are you happy? Is that really what you wanted?
You now have a much better view
of Seaman's ass.
Wait, we can probably do this better.
Stop grabbing me. Come on, let me go. What are you doing? Whoa.
Okay, let's make him happy again. I will give you a name. No, didn't recognize it.
Hello.
I will give you a name.
Okay, I'm going to let you give me a name. When you've decided what you want to call me, say, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
All right then, here's how to do it. You're going to say my new name 3 times. Each time I say now, say the name once. Got it? Now.
Ishmael.
One more time.
Ishmael.
One more time.
Ishmael.
Okay, I'll remember that. Next time you want to call me using that name. And don't forget the name you gave me. Because if you do, I'm not going to tell you what it is. Well, I think that pretty much covers it. Later.
Come on, we're obviously not calling the Seaman Bloody Mary. That would summon something much more pleasant to come talk to us.
Let's tickle this one.
I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
So basically what I learned is before we were often saying things that Seaman didn't understand, which upset Seaman. We're saying the same thing, which also upsets Seaman. And so you can compensate for that either by tickling, or I'll see if I can pull this off because it's a bit tricky. tap on the glass to get both of them over. And now I just keep circling around them and I'll hypnotize them, which makes them happy. So you can kind of see they're following along with their heads. It's a little bit blurry.
I feel dizzy.
There we go. Good times.
Chad wanted us to have named the Seaman Bruce Gillis. Which, in Chad's defense, is great.
Yeah, no, this is true. Talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me.
Yes.
Tell me a story.
What do you want?
A fucking story.
Yes.
But now he's upset. So we've named him. Let's go to the next day, I think.
Okay.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Yes, Leonard Nimoy, I would. Thanks for asking. Okay.
Chad, I'm not sure why you're expecting a healthy relationship from Seaman, a creature that is known for being fratricidal as part of its natural life cycle.
I just want Seaman to love me the same way Seaman loved that Nautilus.
I'm gonna need a lot more time to unpack that statement.
A lot more.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. How many times have you visited today? You visit often. If one didn't know better, one might assume you're quite obsessed. Or you have nothing better to do.
24 hours? Oh, I hit cancel.
Let's see. Last time, you have given a name to one of the gill men. His coloration has changed. So you should be able to locate him easily. Please, take good care of him. At the moment, the habitat contains two gillmen. They are enjoying a comfortable environment. So let us head over to the
This is Leonard Nimoy talking to us. Because this game is perfect in every way.
It's true, Leonard Nimoy is was a science fiction actor best known for playing Galvatron in the 1986 Transformers movie. Plus some
and himself in Seaman.
Yeah.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. Let's see. Last time, you have given a name to one of the gill men. His coloration has changed, so you should be able to locate him easily. Please, take good care of him. At the moment, the habitat contains two gillmen. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Yes, let's.
Yeah, if you're hearing a loud grinding noise in the background, that is the Dreamcast seeking on the disc. It's just very loud. It's just warming like that.
Yeah, that's good. I'm freezing. Oh, sweet oxygen.
If you're hearing another upsetting noise, that would be Seaman.
My fins are frozen. Do something. It's too cold in here. I'm freezing. It's really cold in here. I'm freezing. It's really cold in here. Yay! It's about time. It's about time. I'm warmer now, thanks. I could use a snack.
How are we doing for food?
Oh, we're really good.
Okay.
That tickling really made them grow faster.
I'm a little hungry.
Hopefully we get to raise bugs before.
Yeah, I think we will. Now that I know the tickling trick.
What is it?
Give me fucking food. Eat food.
Well, if you've ever wanted to play Seaman, we are here to teach you why this is an extremely bad idea and...
Yum, food.
Best avoided. What didn't happen on screen was several hours of Miguel just saying random words into the microphone in between working.
Yeah, I did just leave the TV on while I worked in the other room and...
That was damned yummy.
Who the fuck taught you that kind of language?
Me.
Hello?
Yeah, you were saying about... Oh.
Is anyone out there?
Hello? Talk to me.
What's up? Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
Hi, Seaman.
What's up?
Talk to me.
What?
Talk to me. Why is he not recognizing that now? Hello.
What's up?
Talk to me.
Okay, let's talk about... No, maybe tomorrow.
I'll tickle you more.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Talk to me.
What's up? Hey. Hey! I've got something to say. Hello? I just remembered something. Some of my memories are coming back.
No, I do not have kids.
He only has terrible, terrible semen.
They're all my sweet babies.
There was this French man named Jean-Paul Gasset who was trying to raise me. And he made this cage to hold insects. And there were a lot of really tasty looking insects in it. Is it still there? Can you take a look? Okay, so after a while, some moth larvae will start growing in there. When that happens, use the L trigger to switch screens and grab a larva and drop it in here. Can you do that for me?
Excellent.
Wow, it actually explained the mechanic. Yeah, the fade to black was on our end, too. There wasn't anything there.
Just keep on swimming through that hill. Okay, so I think there's some stuff we do need to do in here. What is this? Did you grab any of those? Knock on it. I can spray water to keep it moist.
So you can grow some moths?
Yeah, gotta water the moths. Yeah, I'm guessing we've gotta keep it hydrated the same way we've gotta keep it, the other tank oxygenated and warm. This far, we don't want to kill off another Seaman. Let's see if these ones want to be hypnotized. Come on, some good old Seaman hypnotizing. It'll make you happy.
Hey, slow down.
Yeah, they're blissed out.
Okay, so apparently there's some very upsetting stuff happening in this cage. Just throwing it out there.
Okay. There's a mushroom or...
I'm hungry.
The spray is actually pretty hard for us to see. Unfortunately, the Elgato won't let me run it through the VGA output on the Dreamcast, so we're not getting the best visuals. So even we aren't seeing the spray super clearly. Oh, they're hungry again, weren't they? No? Yes.
Okay, so... the key is to not get rid of all the larva.
Yeah.
Because
oh, yummy baity goodness.
Grow into a moth.
Yeah. And we have to watch out for spiders, apparently, also.
The Nautilus shell got cleared out after the Nautilus got horribly, horribly murdered.
Oh, I'm a fat sea man now.
Good to know. Good to know that. I'm gonna turn off the lights on you guys.
Mother, I'm frightened. Hey, turn on the light so I may see where I'm going. Hey, cut that out. I'm trying to get some sleep here.
Fucking mind.
Oh, I'm blind. Why is it so dark in here?
There.
See you then, disco party.
Just gonna cheer them up and then we'll go to the next day.
Quit it. Quit it. It hurts. Oh, knock it off. I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
Okay, they're both cheered up.
Would you like to save and end the session?
I love the way that, like, the sign, different things will be happening. Sometimes it's raining, sometimes it isn't. For those who missed when we had to kill off our Seaman, we went, like, several decades into the future and the sign gets all, like, progressively more decayed. And it's just an empty tank when you go and visit it. It's kind of dark.
sign does breathe.
Yeah. Except I think after you kill them, it stops breathing.
I think so.
Yeah. And just starts getting more and more, like, rusted and chipped. Thanks, Bodhi Wolf.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. There is a definite pattern to your visits. It appears you are a punctual person.
Or Dodi Cheeto, one of the two.
First, a recap of your previous visit. You have obtained the insect cage.
Yay.
This will be helpful in raising more food for Seaman. Keep your eye on it. Something will happen within shortly. Oh, the spray. The insect cage is equipped with a spray to keep the moisture level up. Please, don't forget to use it. At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gill men. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. Allow me to divulge today's highlights. Gillman has been growing and would love some variety in his meals. Try giving him some larvae from the other tank. I'm sure he'll be pleased. So let us head over to the tank.
This may be Leonard Nimoy's greatest work. Are there any making of documentaries? There aren't, but there's actually a fair amount of info about this, I think because the creator speaks English. So it's actually some really interesting stuff around the marketing of it in Japan that's worth looking up. Where he did like fake news stories about it and stuff.
Yeah, that's good. Could you put the heater on for me?
Yeah.
It won't last long. Oh, by the way,
Goody.
Due to it mishearing something, it thinks I'm 79 in this.
Oh, goody.
Which it will accept. It wouldn't accept 40, but it will accept 79. And it's happy to have a companion near its own age. Which I guess it's in like the weird genetic memory they have age, not really not actual age, because it's only a few days.
Hello?
Something happened.
You gotta check out the app.
Yeah. I just want to get the heater up to the right level.
Hey, you.
I think the air just stops when it hits 100.
I'm saying, hey, you.
Okay, don't answer
me. Hello? Hello, Seaman. Recognize it. Hello, Seaman.
What do you want?
Talk to me. Talk to me. Don't talk to me.
I'm thinking about some food, eh?
Gotcha. Okay, let's have a look at the... Oh.
Where did the...
Oh my god!
No. No, nope, 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 nope.
Well, I definitely forgot that. Apparently, you will eventually forget that. It might take about a decade and a half, but you will forget it. Jesus Christ.
I don't like this. Well, time to feed it to Seaman.
And they hide it, so we may not have seen that. It just happened to be...
What do you want?
I'm feeding you Seaman bugs.
What hath God wrought?
Hey, thanks.
I'm really impressed by the fact that, like, every single aspect of this... Oh, Jesus. Oh!
Oh, come on!
You know, I could really eat. Yum, food. I'm full now.
Yep. Welcome to Seaman, everybody!
That was great. Thanks.
I'm gonna go spray some water so we get more of those delightful bugs.
The miracle of nature.
At least these ones don't talk, they just chitter.
What happens if you try to tickle it?
It does not seem to react to tickling.
I've never been more thankful to not see an interaction implemented in my life.
Look at their little jittery legs.
I don't like it. Oh God, I don't even want to know what it grows into.
Oh hey, it has eye spots. Given its actual eyes, I imagine are in the tucked in head bit. Was eating dinner. Well, you're not anymore. So is Seaman. Let's go visit Seaman. Talk to me.
What's up?
Chat wants to know, is this a prequel to Saya no Uta? No, it's not. There are non-horrifying things in that. This is only horror.
Let's talk about Nintendo.
Blah, blah, blah. Happy?
Let's talk about Sega.
You call it by name.
What was it you call? Oh,
call it Ishmael.
Okay. Ishmael. Ishmael.
What do you want?
Let's talk.
Tell me, what do you do for a living?
Game designer.
Ah, you fix teeth, eh?
No.
Well then, what do you do for a living?
Make games.
You're in the food service industry?
No.
Well then, what do you do for a living?
Games.
You're a stockbroker?
No.
Well then, what do you do for a living?
So the larva turned into moss.
Game developer.
Okay, I'm going to try this again. What do you do for a living? You know, what's your job?
Games.
You're a stockbroker?
No.
Well, then what do you do for a living?
I'm a programmer.
Programmer. Okay, I'm going to try this again. What do you do for a living?
Programmer.
You know, what's your job?
Programmer.
You're a housekeeper?
No.
Well, then what do you do for a living?
Computers.
Okay, I'm going to try this again.
I'm gonna look up what the jobs it knows are.
You know, what's your job?
Artist.
You're an artist?
Yes.
If you ask me, the secret of being an artist is to always see the world with new eyes. Or maybe you just need a really good agent.
Frankly, I'm surprised that that was a Seaman approved job.
Talk to me.
Well, until next time. Bye.
Let's give them their tickles, make sure everything's ready and all the things, and go to the next day.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
You need some tickles.
Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
Make sure we're all sprayed up. And air is good. I'll try that. How old are you? How old are you? Doesn't get it.
Yes.
How old are you?
I don't even know myself. Do you know?
Yes, you're 5.
Yes.
The spray is just water. It's keeping them nice and moist.
So that they grow mini, mini larvae with human heads.
Why are we doing this again?
Would you like to save and end the session?
Well, I can't argue with Spock.
Who can? He's so logical. Really glad I remembered how to reboot using the controller, because it definitely makes this bit easier. Gilman to scale. I think like when you see them hold being held with the hand, yeah, that is their scale.
It definitely means the larvae are already upsettingly huge.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. There is a definite pattern to your visits. It appears you are a punctual person. First, a recap of your previous visit. The eggs in the insect cage have hatched into larvae. It is important to raise them carefully. If you put too many larvae into the tank, you may find yourself running out of food for Seaman later. But if you manage the larvae well, you should have no problem keeping Seaman well fed. At the moment, the habitat contains 2 Gilmen. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
Oh, there was a pun we missed.
That was not very good. You can just change the date back and nothing will happen. It's very, there's no Animal Crossing style, super strict time enforcement.
Although one...
Hey, it's a bit cold in here.
Once they're dead, they're dead. And no amount of time manipulation will get you out of that.
It's about...
If you set it back, basic letter Mimoy says, something's wrong, like, fix the bait.
Oh, goody.
I mean, as if Spock is one to talk about time paradoxes.
I thought I was going to die. I'm thinking about some food, eh?
Of them, and then, oh, we're growing some plants. Should we feed it maybe regular food this time?
I think so, yeah.
Just give them a chance to reproduce. Yeah.
What do you want? Hey, thanks.
That one steal it from the other?
I'm not sure how that worked.
Oh, I'm a fat seaman now. Hey, you.
Yes? Yes?
It'll cost you a buck.
I do not understand this interaction. Hello.
Well, hello.
Talk to me.
What do you want?
Talk to me. Okay, the tickle's for you.
What? Oh, knock it off.
That one has no name.
It is the nameless.
It is the Seaman with no name.
Named Seaman of Gold. Oh, something's happening.
Drop me. Now. Come on, let me go.
I'm bigger.
Drop me.
Yep.
Now. Oh. I come from Alabama with my banjo on my knee. Oh. What are you doing?
What the fuck? I did not expect it to break into song.
Someone over here wants to eat.
That's why he's not cheering up when I tickle him.
Yum, food.
Chat has lots of questions. Nobody has answers.
It probably knows it from genetic memory. That was probably Jean-Paul's favorite song.
Oh, well, that may... Wait, what?
That was great. Thanks.
Ah, yes, that old French ditty.
Yes!
Quit it, it hurts.
There we go, yeah. Cheered up. Talk to me.
I was wondering, are you married?
Nope.
You're unmarried?
Yep.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, that's okay. Don't listen to people who say you need to get married. It's an antiquated notion, really.
Glad to know Seaman's opinions of social...
What do you know about social norms, Seaman? You were born 5 days ago.
Yes, but Seaman has genetic memory of marriage. Also, what does Seaman marriage look like?
I'm guessing we're gonna find out.
Talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me. It's not going to destroy anything. Talk to me.
Incidentally, progressive fish is my favorite subgenre.
Tell me something. Do you like girls?
Yes.
Then do you have a girlfriend?
No.
You're single?
Yes.
But you still date people, right?
Yes.
Well, that's a relief. I was starting to think you were some kind of recluse.
Yes.
Don't lie to Seaman. I mean, what happens if he tells Seaman that you're gay?
I'm guessing it handles that.
Damn, should've.
Yeah, no, we could've tested.
Should've gone for it.
Well, clearly it's not detecting whether or not I'm bi, because I would've had to ask. Hello?
Well,
once
hello.
Once again, you were let down by the progressive fish.
Yeah. Talk to me.
Something. So you're single. Do you live alone?
Yes.
So you live alone then?
Yes.
You do? It's hard to see, but you're probably sitting there in your underwear right now. Hey, not that there's anything wrong with that. If you're comfortable, I'm comfortable.
Talk to me. Talk to me.
So listen, do you have any kids?
No.
So you don't have any kids right now, is that correct?
Correct. Yes.
I see. No kids. Are you thinking of having some in the future?
No.
Good. I won't have to share your attention with a bunch of rugrats.
You've taught me the danger of childhood.
They might murder your Nautilus?
Yes. Talk to me.
I am. I'm swimming.
Talk to me. Check one. Oh, looks like something's happening to one of them.
Is it turning into a cocoon, maybe?
I don't know if it's turning into a cocoon.
Or might just be dead.
Dying.
Is it nice and moist?
Yeah, it's nice and moist in there, so it shouldn't be dead. Unless they murdered it. With their creepy little hands. What do you think going on around the flowers? No. How's this one looking? Yeah, it's got that annoying smoke. It's happy. Hello. Sega. Sega. Sega? Is it not registering anything? Sega. Talk to me. Wow, yeah, they're just ignoring me. Might be time for the next day.
Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
think they're both happy.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
If this came out today for smartphones, I'd assume these questions were just Seaman trying to get data to target ads at me.
I really hope that the flowers do not have faces.
I'll try one more. Talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me.
About what?
Sega. Yeah, they refuse to talk to me about Sega. Sega must be hiding something. Sony. PlayStation.
What?
Okay, the tickle's for you, and then we'll do one final day, and then...
Yeah, sure.
See if we can get them into the next form or not.
I don't like it one bit.
Is the other one gonna eat a leaf? Look at it crawl up the branch. Adorable. Insects getting bigger? I think they are getting bigger.
Yeah, they grow bigger than they form cocoons. I guess maybe the other one's just dead.
I didn't believe you when you said that larvae have human faces. I guess you missed it when we saw it briefly on screen before it hit its hideous face.
Yeah, the insects turn to cocoons and then they turn to moths. Yeah, the stream will be put up on YouTube after the fact.
Yeah, we missed one. We missed last stream because I was in the middle of a Kickstarter and forgot to hit the upload. But most of what we've done has been archived. We just haven't been, like, we haven't made the page pretty or anything, so...
Yeah.
Haven't set up links to it or anything. But you can catch up on the early life of Seaman. I would recommend not doing that, but you can if you want to.
It's a bad time. Shall we do one more day?
Yeah, let's do it. Just quickly check on these ones. They're all good.
We've been trying to do our best to never remember this.
Yeah, they're just swimming up. What? What is that? You.
Okay, can we not zoom in on that?
I guess they shat, and we missed it.
Would you like to save and end?
Well, you just need the moths in order to produce more eggs. I'm not sure what the deal is with the moths. You want to check?
Yeah, I think it's just reduced larva.
So we can't feed? I imagine if it lets us pick them up, we can feed them. But maybe they want to have, the, like, if they don't have the little faces, maybe they're like, no, these don't have little faces on them, so we're not going to eat them. They're like, you know, two-year-olds. They need faces on their food. see if that worked or not. So how about that Ecco the Dolphin?
Good evening. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. First, a recap of your previous visit. Oh, yes. They have started to produce droppings. The tubes on their heads serve many purposes.
Blood sucking, pooping.
At the moment, the habitat contains 2 gill men.
They are suffering from the cold.
Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
I'm really curious how the caveman figure into Seaman 2. Has there been a fan translation or anything? Like,
I would be a little bit surprised.
I'm freezing.
Yes.
I'm freezing.
No, they only feed blood off of their head tube. They eat using their mouth.
Yay! Listen up.
Yes? Was it the other one who was talking to me? Oh, no. Hello? Yes?
I think I need some food.
Let's see how these guys are doing. Oh, they make... What is the deal with this one? I guess we were supposed to just... Like,
yeah,
it keeps the number to a certain.
Maybe there's only good two.
Yeah. Oh, I shouldn't spray.
So I'm deciding not to spray is water and not pesticide.
Unlike the other stuff where you...
it's a cocoon.
Yeah. Let's just watch that. Nature is beautiful.
Still doing something.
Yeah, no. I'm just trying to... Oh, there. It's a little leg coming out.
Yeah.
It's a miracle of both, sort of. Oh, it definitely has a face. I can see.
Oh, God. The moth will lay more eggs.
Yeah, no, that's why we're being careful about what we feed them.
Sticking its leggy out real far.
I love how willing to be, like, slow and ridiculous this game is.
Yeah.
Oh. Still climbing up and eating stuff.
What happens if you tap on the glass?
Nothing. These aren't as reactive as the Seaman are. I can't grab it. It takes a while for its, like, wings to dry out or whatever. Yeah, its wings are slowly unfolding. Beautiful. Can you talk to them? I don't think so. I'll try. Hello, moth. Hi, moth. Have some water, moth. You're a good moth. A plus, please never turn around. Yeah, I feel like any other game would have, like, done this really quickly.
Yeah.
But instead they're like, no, gotta simulate, like, the actual... Oh. I think that was one of them toning into, yeah.
Yeah.
So we can probably feed the other one to them.
Yeah.
Safely.
Did you already feed Seaman?
I have not fed Seaman yet today. Oh. Is it too late to grab this one? Or is it having trouble because it's overlapping the other one?
Well, that's a bomb.
Yeah. We've got other food.
Or I can just wait until it moves out of the way.
Yeah. There we go. Okay, gonna go feed Seaman. Let's get nice and close up on that.
Hey, thanks for the food.
It looks like me.
That.
Yeah, I don't think in this case it is a case of somebody is asking, I hate it when they artificially extend a game's length. I don't think this is, because we could just be not watching it. It's more that they're trying to, like, get this very weird, slow-paced...
horrible thing.
Horrible virtual pet. Like, the intention of this game is you're playing a little bit every day, and then coming back to it the next day.
And right now, it's still unfolding on screen.
Yeah. It's like we can go check on it, and yeah, it's...
Oh, it moved.
Yeah. Oh!
I don't like it! I don't like it at all.
Can I grab it? Yeah, so we can feed them as well if we needed to.
should be well fed now.
Well, shall we answer some more questions?
First I'm gonna tickle him so he's in a good mood.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop. Masher. Masher. Let me go. What are you doing?
Seaman can definitely die.
You're crushing me.
We really fucked it up the last time.
Yeah, we need to keep the mating pair alive.
Whoa. Watch the fins. Come on, let me go.
Big.
Hey, do I grab you? Oh.
It's true. We dodged a bullet on the cocoon also having a face.
I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
Okay, yeah, they're both in a good mood. Talk to me. Talk to me.
If you have more than two Seaman, they start murdering each other.
You're loading something?
No, not today. Maybe tomorrow.
Hypnotize it?
I can try hypnotizing them. There we go. Hypnotizing time.
This might be ugly. You may want to look away.
Still gonna hypnotize him.
Make it stop. I think I can. I think I can.
But one of them didn't eat. Neither of them ate.
I think one of them ate.
Okay. And they both seem to be in a good mood. Try to talk to me one last time. And then we'll call it a day till next week. Talk to me. Talk to me.
No, it's not the cold one.
Yeah, but sometimes this one will talk. Talk to me. Ishmael. Not registering anything. Ishmael. Ishmael.
Okay.
Yeah, give it a try. It's not even not recognizing, it's just not doing anything.
Ishmael. Ishmael.
Is it giving me any sort of
icon? Ishmael. No. Talk to me. Hello. Hello.
Heck, they might just be
hello, Seaman. Talk to me. Fishmael.
The only answer's to Bruce Gillis. Okay, let's just check that all the things are in a good position.
Oh, it looks like it just shook off. Hypnosis? What's on now?
I don't think that that's how that works, but... Hello! Hello! Yeah, no, I think it's just they're done for the day.
Who turned out the lights? I want the light on.
It's too bright.
Hello. Hi, Moth. Let's hang out and do moth things.
I like the moths better.
I don't like either of them.
Make the moths moist. It's important. Okay.
I think we're done.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Okay. So give us a sec. We're just going to switch things over to Christine's computer so we can do some Super Nintendo.
And Sega CD.
Oh yeah, wait. No, one Super Nintendo, the other Sega CD.
Yep. Ecco the Dolphin for the Sega CD.
Okay, pass me the HDMI. Chuck Mothis. Christine's laptop. Over to HDMI. Wish this stuff would just auto-detect.
Yeah.
It would make it a lot easier for us. I think we keep it at standard, was what we did last time. Yeah. I think as soon as you put a proper game in there, it'll...
Yeah.
Fit. And let me just remember to change our, what game we're playing. So I think what we're gonna do, because these levels can be long and super hard, we'll do each one for a little bit. If we get stuck for too long, we'll skip to the next area. So we can just see as much of it as possible.
Oh, that's a blocking one.
Yeah, it is very weird the way that the blocking ones and the key ones look the same.
I'm not
sure why they weren't different colored or something. I love this crazy tile set though.
Yeah.
I'm not even sure how it's tiling stuff.
Yeah, no.
It's a really weird, interesting. Like the best addition for this area. Not sure how the sharks swim into giant frozen.
Yeah, I'm not sure that really follows.
Thank you.
We could, somebody was asking if we could just turn on invincibility. We could, and it would make it a bit easier, but often the things that we really got stuck on wasn't dying.
It wasn't dying or drowning,
but some of the stuff that was timed where we had to like manipulate an object using our echolocation. Yeah, you could keep going from when I was back before.
Jeez.
Ooh, fishies.
There we go, fish. Delicious fish. Okay, let's not go down there. That's just spiders. Two buttons at once.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, they're not so bad if you use that.
There's an attack, just use them from a distance.
Before they actually...
Yeah, before they trigger.
No, it doesn't look like there's anything this way.
I'm scandalized by the prominence of dolphin genital slits in the sprite work for this game.
Is that a thing? No, that's a spin. That's...
Like when you're going up or down?
No. Ecco is always facing top. Up. That's not... No, that's not Ecco's dick.
That one bit of John C. Lilly is not faithfully reproduced.
Thank God! Wait, was there something involved? No. No.
In Ecco 3, Ecco spends the entire time living in someone's living room.
I don't like this. I feel like you're gonna have to explain that in one of the chat, and...
And I'm not going to. They can use Google.
I definitely think it makes sense that, like,
the chats are explaining everything fine.
Oh no. I mean, you realize that's, like, right there, right? Oh, okay, now we're at the edge.
Did you ever find, like, this? Did you
no, I still haven't found the crystal yet.
Yeah.
It's gotta be here. It's gotta be here somewhere. Maybe down on this side?
Want to try. No, if you missed the first stream about Ecco the Dolphin that we did, the name and a bunch of other stuff in the game is inspired by the work of John C. Lilly, who was a scientist who did a bunch of important stuff having to do with neuroscience and brains and dolphins, and then went full Timothy Leary. He also invented the isolation tank for the CIA, and Ecco actually comes from a galactic organization sort of bureaucracy that he hallucinated while on a LSD or ketamine trip in an isolation tank. Which does mean that Ecco Jr. means that Sega did make a dolphin kids game named after a ketamine trip hallucination. The world is wonderful and strange.
But mostly strange.
No, they actually changed the lighting so that it's highlighted. The lighting's a little bit strange on the top and down ones, but they're definitely being seen from the top.
Yeah, you can see.
The way the transitions are animated, you can tell. I need your passcode.
Oh.
Thank you. Ecco has two backs. Is Ecco the beast with two backs? Pretty sure it's not mirroring for sprite limitation reasons. They
there
do
are so
yeah.
many. Like, watch this rotation. This is all.
If you rotate clockwise versus counterclockwise, it uses different sprites
yeah, it has
to
different
animate correctly.
Sprites for that.
We loaded up
These
the sprite
different.
Sheet last time to show everyone, and it's pretty crazy. They did such a good job on that dolphin.
That might be why the enemies are so unanimated.
Yeah.
The sharks don't animate either, actually.
Yeah. I wonder if in Ecco the Dolphin 2 they do a lot more...
I wonder.
...sprite animation. Because it may have also just been a budget thing versus being a technical thing. Tiger shark coming straight at you, really know your starting point. Turn left and quickly leap out of the water. Instead of bouncing on the island, you'll skid across the water. Nick, jump across the first hole you see using C. Fall into the next one. Now head down, shooting the jellyfish with your death sonar. If you charge them, it'll take two hits. Once you reach the bottom, turn left. It's an evil sea spider. Again, use the death sonar on it. Continue along the path, following the path of the floor. Death sonar every sea spider you see or you'll be overwhelmed. After a while, you'll come to the key glyph. Now head along the roof, killing the sea spiders. Take the next hole up and jump into the ice. Slide across the ice, jumping the first hole you see. Land in the second and get the fish for a health boost. Now continue sliding right.
Okay.
So yeah.
Which hole am I supposed to be
in? You're at the starting one.
Yes, the start.
So, left and jump over the first hole that you hit, is what they said. So it sounds like you might be able to jump while you're sliding. Nope. Stupid ghost sharks.
Okay. Oh, you can!
Oh, cool.
It's the dash button. Okay, so down here?
Yeah. And it suggests sonaring because it'll kill things faster. Death sonaring. And
I'm
death
still
son-
not really sure how the death sonar works. It doesn't really seem to be quite that precise.
It might be a rolling action where you've got to roll one way or the other across the controller.
I think that's a factor.
Close to death.
Very close to death. Alright, let's get that another shot. If the unanimated enemies are an aesthetic choice, I don't think it's a very good one. Like, the crabs are definitely, they sort of stand out as being a little weird.
Yeah, my guess is it either was a budget thing or a technical thing.
Yeah, see, I got
and
that.
And more likely a budget thing.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Okay. First, I want to grab some fish.
Okay. I think they're also the other way.
No.
Okay. You know better than I do.
Get out of the way, you fucking jellyfish.
Oh.
Brutal.
I feel like some of the other, like, earlier shark things we saw did have animation.
Possible. Yeah, it's possible that these ones.
The killer whales have a fair amount, from what I remember. So yeah, that leans me towards thinking that it was a budgetary thing, that later on they're like, well, we need more anime variety, but we don't have the money to animate these. It's interesting that they didn't do at least two frames, though, because that's not very expensive.
Yeah.
Ecco is expensive.
I mean, it might also just be fine.
Yeah.
Oh. Fucked it up.
Good night, Scorpio 2048.
And not even some sort
of animal. Oh wait, no, that wasn't the one. It was Bodhi Wolf was leaving. Good night, Bodhi Wolf. I'm not good at reading as a child.
Okay, it's just all the way in the right. Yeah.
I think so. I thought that was the one thing you knew where to get to, so. I wasn't looking at the... Yeah, there you go.
Fuck it up. Yeah, sometimes I get it right, sometimes I don't. Oh, that was it.
Dark hole does ding. Water stones move. The distant songs continue.
Hard
and then it has the name of one of the great old ones, Yahang Slum.
Oh, jeez.
They've got edges you can't swim
through.
Okay,
they have an attack animation.
Ah, that was the move. Oh, hard water.
Okay, the sharks do have... They just didn't animate in that one because they...
They never turned?
Because they didn't attack. Didn't turn. Okay, so hard water is ice.
No, they've got a chomp. It's one of the hardest ones, one of them.
Oh god. I'm feeling it. This is definitely like, I'm not really sure.
Alternately, drop the word water from the level name, because it's just plain hard. The crushing ice cubes are annoying for the most part, until you reach the end of the level and it becomes a death trap. Whenever hell froze over, they called it hard water.
Okay, so GameFAQ author has strong feelings on this level.
Do you want instructions?
Let's
okay.
Keep going.
I think that's not that they insta-kill, that they crush, and that crush is an
insta-kill. Yeah, it crushes you against the wall, and that kills you.
So it's like touching
the... Which is very normal, but...
Yeah.
Like, that's a bit... However, you don't normally have this sort of movement.
Yeah, there's like a...
And they have like a really weird curve to them. Like, it's not a predictable... Or it's predictable, but...
It feels like it's the same weird physics that the spiders use for movement. It's like everything's on a,
Yeah, they have like really weird patterns.
A sort of, elastic.
Like, even like that very first one is sort of, two blocks that...
Oh, nice.
And by nice, you mean dash and got lucky.
Yes, but you did it nicely.
Okay. Let's just try this as fast as... direction.
Fishies. Creepy looking fish. Too many fish legs.
They're just stripes. It's fine.
Got one thing really, really right, and then everything else.
A lot of things really wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, but that fast swimming is just so satisfying.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I need to breathe badly.
No, I really want to see a mod that takes this and just does like a that game company.
Oh, come on.
It takes like a that game company approach to it, where it's just about fun swimming.
Yeah. Because swimming is really good.
Yeah, I know. It's amazing.
It's really satisfying.
Especially for like a 16-bit game to have that sort of feel to it. Get to it, turn left and return the way you came, past the three ice cubes.
Damn it.
Once you reach the surface, slide left if you need health. To be honest, it's not really worth it, as the sea spiders are always regenerates and will probably kill you. Instead, slide right back into the shock pool. Back down
cool.
in the middle
Great.
Of the
awesome.
Pool, turn the sea spiders that appear. Moving past the ice cube, going to and fro, unfortunately you dodge past it. Use your dolphin skills to get past the next two. It's safe to wait between them if you're careful.
Okay, so which one am I going?
Oh, Jesus, okay. You're not at the hard bit yet! There's a bit that the author describes as a mosh pit of ice cubes.
Okay, so what's the next password? I feel like we've gotten the experience.
Yeah, we've
We're
gotten
good.
The experience. We know what this one's about. Fucking ice cubes.
They're probably talking about this bullshit.
I don't think so.
They're talking about the bullshit after that.
Yeah, okay. So after hard water is cold water.
Okay.
So
how do I just have to restart?
Let me know when you're ready to. S Y Q J H S L Z or Z.
Cold water.
Is someone saying that they felt like these levels in general were like the weak point of the game?
Oh, more.
Oh, seems like it might be a different music. Forgot how it started. Oof.
Makes sense. Why are the crabs getting up on my dick? It's not like they don't eat dolphins.
You don't know about the long war between crabs and dolphins?
There is only peace between our peoples.
Also,
why must I fight
really,
you, crab?
Really,
we are not
really
enemies.
Spider crab. Like, thinking about the scale.
It could probably.
Let me know when you want the next code.
Yeah, okay, we had some fun here, crabs, but you win this battle.
Okay, so next one's Open Ocean 2, which might not be interesting, but we'll find out.
Oh, it's probably another.
Yeah.
We did okay on that one.
And then there's the Island Zone after that, which
cool.
Sounds like it'll be a new tile set. The next bunch sound like they might be new tile sets.
Chad points out, I'd definitely be interested to see what the speedrun of this is like, because those ice cubes feel like...
A previous time that people were talking about this on chat, they said that generally, like, it's all about clipping, because you can get so much speed because of the physics
sense.
Engine.
Yeah, I could see that.
I'd love to see a non-clipping, like,
okay, give me an open ocean.
One. Okay, CCV FF SLM.
Okay, that's slowed way down. CCV
FF SLM.
The open ocean is cold and dangerous.
Look at the end of cold water. There's quite some dialogue and a thing at the end, okay? So we'll play through this one properly. Thanks.
Oh, cold water is the last one. Cold water is the last one.
Oh, okay. So we should go. Soon. the keyboard has finally given up. It's more energy.
Okay, good.
Okay, so we'll go back and try cold water.
Yeah, just give me the walk.
S.
Okay.
So we're gonna go back to cold water since apparently there's some stuff we'll want to see at the end of it.
Gotta get that plot.
Do you want to unlock some cheats to get through it to help us?
I feel like that wasn't like.
Okay.
Okay. So what's the password?
SYQJH. SLZ.
Who taught you to say that letter that way?
I'm a dual citizen.
Is that on the test? Okay, so just like get a walkthrough on how to do this because this is some real.
Okay, give me a second to get to the walkthrough. Yeah. Okay.
Is it just a big spike party?
You finally reach Big Blue. This level's a refreshing change after the hell that is hard water. No more ice cubes, hooray! Upon trying to surface at the start, you'll encounter spikes. You may also notice a sea spider floating precariously close to the starting position. Death sonar, and indeed any others. Head down into the right, then down into the left. Gonna go while you do that. I'm gonna plug in the keyboard so that we have some juice soon for it. Anything still streaming? Okay, chat's been quiet.
Chat, if you're alive, say something. Well, more like if we're alive, say something.
They're still here, they said something.
What was happening was that there was a downward flow of water, so it was pushing us down faster than the dash would make us go up.
So I'm trying to figure out which bit you're at.
I've gotten the key.
You've gotten the key. There's a strong current. Find a key glyph. So potential to get the power. Now slide along the ice again, jumping over the first hole. There are some spikes lying on top of the ice. Jump holding down C for extra distance to clear them. After clearing the spikes, you'll land in the next hole.
Fuck.
Oh.
Okay, so don't do a lot of damage though. Wait, shit, did I want to be in that hole?
Yeah.
That's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Everything's fine.
Yeah, so go back to two holes over.
Yeah, I'm just...
Spiders, follow the passageway around, don't bother checking for air pockets, there aren't any. Just swim like crazy until you get to the barrier glyph. Sonar it out of the way and continue on. There.
Ah.
You'll reach a large iceberg. Go around the underside and collect the key glyph power. Then swim all the way right until you find it.
Fish.
Fish. Use your sonar to get rid of those. Oh, there, that glyph, get it. Shit. So go down and around, I think it says. Go on the underside, collect the key glyph.
Whoa!
Swim all the way
whoa!
Back until you find.
Whoa! Okay, I found them.
Of life vanish in the eye of the storm. Not little singer, there is one older and wiser than I. It is called the asteroid, and we think it is the oldest life form of the sea. I don't know if you thought from the asteroid, it will not sing to us. Communicate with it, perhaps you could help. It could help you. Deep water zone. Whoa! Big sprite. We get some water or some air from that. Big Blue, which is not sure if it's actually pulled up the last time to Big Blue. So no, turns out Big Blue is actually a big fraud, but you know, someone with actual intelligence can help you out. The asteroids, that's who you've got to meet next. Go back the way you came and shoot away the barrier glyph. Use the underwater passage to get to the surface before you drown. On the surface, slide to the right. You'll land in a small pool.
There is not an encouraging word in there. Okay. Some fish. Okay, so run that by me again.
Go back the way you came and shoot away the barrier glyph. So there should be a barrier glyph. Probably down lower, it looked like. Oh no.
No, there's nothing lower.
I guess.
Okay.
There.
Oh, there. Okay, now what?
Use the underwater passage to get to the surface before you drown. On the surface, slide to the right. You'll land in a small pool. Oh, no.
Cold and dangerous, but at least there are no goddamn spiders.
Thanks, Chibi Plan, for telling us about that. It would have sucked to miss the
Big Blue.
Okay. apparently this bit is something that's only in the Sega CD version.
Oh.
I don't know if that's the case for the other open ocean bed.
Interesting once you realize the dash is really exploitable.
Yeah. Don't all sharks in this boat, please.
I'm gonna murder a bunch of sharks.
Side quest we can do in this one, apparently.
Okay. I've got a brave proposal here.
Yeah.
Let's not do that.
That sounds good.
Just throwing that one out there. So I feel like the problem that these have is that, like, none of these levels have, like, distinguishing features.
Yeah, I know. The
There's
fact
never,
that
they... There's no landmarks in general. The last level did, like with the spikes, those were pretty good landmarks, but in general, like, there's nothing to distinguish.
Yeah, no, it's definitely a problem that they sort of went with, like, really large tiles so that they look nice, but you don't get any sense of...
Don't give me this weak-ass tutorial shit. I know that.
Set and also sometimes the geometry not being doing
oh,
a lot of
the
mimicking.
The geometry is all.
So we have to push them somewhere.
Fuck. Wait, what? Wait, is it damage?
I guess so. Yes.
I don't know. That's not.
It might be the same weird background island from the start of the game.
Yeah.
I think it's just been long enough since we've seen that.
Yeah. Which definitely leads me to think budget issues. Yeah, sure.
Okay, y'all. Okay, from the starting point, scrim right in under the rock. You'll find a not-so-friendly shark here. Use the death sonar on it, or just dodge it. There is a rock on the edge of the lower platform. Push it off the edge and ride it down to get past the current. Hello!
Body.
Okay, from here you have two options. One is quicker.
Hey.
Follow the roof of the cavern to the right. Dive under the rock, over the other side, and get the key glyph. Beware, as soon as you get the glyph, evil starfish will appear. You can't sonar them to break open rocks. They prefer to break Ecco instead. So yeah, they're slightly different color.
Okay.
They are. Is.
I see. That was a bad time.
Yeah, no, that was not fun. Crab on an elastic.
Okay, so where am I going now?
Okay, follow the roof of the cavern to the right, dive under the rock and over the other side to get the key glyph. Beware, as soon as you get the glyph, you can starfish, okay?
Got it.
Head out of the cave, then back to the surface to get some air. Return to the starting point and leap across the four islands. How strange.
Wait, did they mean one around?
Yeah, that's the gap. Leave the cave the way you came and get some air from the surface before heading down again.
Okay, great, awesome.
Move around the spike platform and under it, and then this is going to be octopus.
Okay, so where am I going?
So head down, maneuver around the spiked platform, and under it.
Okay.
Yeah, just now. Carefully now.
Yeah, where now?
Yeah, we're looking for the octopus.
Okay.
Jesus. Okay, there.
Shit.
Oh. How far back does it send us? Yeah, we're all the way back at the start. You want to go next level?
Let's try once more.
Okay. Oh, you went into, you did the optional thing.
That was not useful.
Yeah. That's why it's optional. I'll talk to...
Alright, talk.
Okay.
Set that. You know, set the entire ocean. There's a storm. Alright, let's,
Okay, next level.
Yeah, no, this is definitely a game that makes me want to play Aquaria.
I'd love to see some good hacks of this with levels that are made more around exploring and just the joy of the movement, because the movement is just so good.
And I do feel like the levels need to add, like, points of interest.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like if there are more challenges based around going fast, that would be good.
Yeah, no, like
those are interesting challenges. What's not interesting is challenges based around randomly not getting killed by ice.
Yeah, and the enemy movement is like
Shit.
A lot of the enemy movement is just very weird.
This music is in the Sega CD version, so it's like music that's actually on CD. In the original Genesis version, it's not quite as interesting because Genesis music tends to not be very interesting. There's some exceptions. Some people do good work with the limited stuff available. Like the Sonic games actually have pretty good...
The problem is I understand it with the Genesis is that it never had a great soundtrack, especially compared to the Super Nintendo.
Well, the Super Nintendo like had sampled sounds, whereas
on
the Genesis you had a single synthesizer. So,
but also you had multiple different chips used, so they couldn't even like plan
also
on how
help.
It's gonna sound.
All right, what's next?
Okay, so we did Volcanic Reef. So that sounds like it looked different.
Do we want to? Is it Island?
Oh no, that was where we were, wasn't it?
So
we did deep water. Oh, no,
we didn't do deep water.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. IHPF. DSLP.
Yeah, so there's a thing where, like, Sonic 3 did, in fact, have, like, the rumor that it was Michael Jackson doing tracks, it turned out to actually be true, but the reason why his name isn't attached is because he wasn't happy with how they sounded on the on the Genesis hardware.
Is that the first, like, this is a long history of Michael Jackson doing stuff in Sega games. Is that the first case, or was it?
I think so, yeah.
So that was before he actually had a game with them.
Yeah. Well, there's that, and then they're like, he had a cameo on Space Channel 5, but, like, I don't think the cameo was, in the first one was...
It's pretty small in the first one.
Yeah,
and
then,
it's
and
much
then he saw it and
the
was like, no, I want more.
Then he's also in a boxing game from that era as a character.
That's wild. Space Michael plays a big role in Space Channel
5
Part 2.
Yeah.
These crabs, I feel like they have, like, 2 frames.
I have yet to see a second frame. But I've looked for it. Yeah, I think you're just seeing the shimmer from the filter.
Might as well.
Yeah. Okay, it's not supposed to be hard at all. It's
yeah, this wasn't seeming. It felt like it was pretty straightforward. It's just a hard game.
Head left of your starting point. So
yeah, yeah, I don't think.
You've got an idea what to do.
Yeah.
That's supposed to be one of the easiest levels in the game, so.
God damn it.
Here is a game where you can find the health power up and die trying to eat it. Yeah, I think like one of the things I would have, like, I would do differently in the design of this is make it so that you can just run into fish and eat them.
Yeah, definitely.
Like have them give less health or whatever or to compensate, but.
Ah, yeah, now the party started.
Let me see the DNA meter.
Oh, I see.
Okay.
Sorry.
Blue book 6. Ooh. Before your time, but not before crabs.
Oh, we haven't gone back yet. We're still on.
Another great tile set here, though.
Yeah.
Like, the tile sets are really interesting and organic. Unfortunately, I think it probably uses up all of their space for doing variation.
I feel like there's a problem with, like, the tile sets are really interesting. In terms of the variation, but they...
Like, they don't stand out from each other.
Yeah, exactly. So.
Yeah.
Granted. soundtrack is really good. I really like this a lot.
Yeah.
Is next Atlantis?
I don't think so. I think it'll be another. I think ship grave seal.
Oh jeez. You don't. I think Deep City is. Yeah. Wow. That's
yeah.
A long way to go before you travel in time.
I don't know how many of these are the ones that were specific to the Sega CD version. But yeah, the next thing is Ship Grave Seal, which hopefully will have some ships in it.
Okay, let's do one more and then we'll switch over.
And then we'll switch over to EVO.
Yeah, we ran a bit long, so.
Yeah.
I think we'll keep EVO a little briefer.
Okay.
Yeah, jeez, I wanna go fucking Atlantis.
There are a lot of levels. Like, this is a long game.
It's really long.
I can only imagine if we were actually trying to beat each level how long this would last.
I mean, definitely like the password then, you know, makes it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like the penultimate level has been really hyped up. Okay, so what? Ship Grave Seal?
Yeah, it's N-Wug-Slew. N-W-U. G S L U.
Oh, so it's spelled like it sounds. Wait.
Huh.
Let's try that again.
N W U G S L U.
I don't think they typed that correctly.
Yeah, I don't think they did. I guess we'll go to the next one.
Let's just, yeah. Okay.
W-J-H-Q G-S-L-L. That is so like Turtles.
Fucking Turtles.
Oh, that's what I saw that I thought was a shark.
That was a rock.
Yeah, I just like saw the edge of it, so it looked like it was some sort of creature. Yeah, so
yeah.
This is what it needs more of.
Although I'm guessing like there's probably gonna be a lot of those.
Yeah. But no, like, doing, like, bits and pieces of them. Like, the problem is partially that they have... Most of the levels have one tile set. And so you can't even, like, mix it in interesting ways. Oh, the background even has the ships. Not here, but in the other bit there was some open water. And you can see...
Yeah. I see, that's probably what it means.
There's probably something we need to do using them. Oh, I bet we can use them in their shell form as...
That sounds, yeah.
Something to drift with.
However, now we're gonna try.
Yep, so now it goes down. I see we can shove it.
So the reason why the rocks hurt is because they're destroyable, which means they want you to make these enemies go away. So you attack them. However, that also means if you bump into them, you take damage. Which is why you don't program things that way. It's stupid. That's...
Yeah, no, I do wonder how much of the flaws in the game are due to budget stuff.
And, like, how much stuff was it? So the reason why I like something like that would happen is because it probably was implemented very late. Once, like, they finalized the data structure, which is, you know, kind of weird. Maybe they should have just played around that.
Also, it's all assembly at this point, so...
Oh yeah, sure, but... That's what I mean. So, like, you probably have to add... You'd add another byte saying it does this damage when you touch it. No, except they already have that. Okay. I don't think this is what it's supposed to. So they have those starfish. They have the starfish, and some of them do damage. Like, the ones early in the game, they don't do damage to you, but the ones later in the game do.
Yeah, you're right. Neither of them are destroyable.
Yeah.
I feel like most of the flaws I see in the game are due to bad decisions. Yeah, the question is whether those bad decisions were, like... I wonder if so much time was spent getting just the swimming to feel good that, that there just wasn't a lot of time to make the right decisions.
Decisions.
Yeah, no, that's very strange.
Do you want to turn up the mic volume?
Yeah, sure.
Possible?
The mic is at full volume.
Okay.
I'll move it closer. I definitely get, like, dizzy. I wonder if they sort of just, like, I wonder if they just had an idea and didn't know what to do with it. And I feel like that definitely is part of it.
Oh, come on. Nope.
Like, I feel like this is a game that's central mechanic would do well in a time once the idea that games could be easy was...
Yeah.
An idea, and that just wasn't an idea.
No.
At this time. Partially for economic reasons, because we know that some of the difficulty is due to
making it easier, harder, so you couldn't finish it in the span of
a weekend when you rented it.
So something that makes that make a lot more sense is that we found out that this the game's American. It was developed in California. So you can tell, like, they're making decisions based off, you know, America having a rental market, which isn't necessarily the case in Japan. That wasn't a big thing.
No, I've definitely also heard other American devs talk about that with games at this time.
Yeah.
Invincibility?
Yeah. Okay, that's weird, but also not actually helpful.
I'm sure it's helpful. Oh, maybe you can swim through currents with it? EVO is up later. We'll be doing it soon. It's just hiding in its shell, right? Ecco didn't hit it too hard. Yeah, it's just hiding in its shell. It's over-animated shell.
You know what this really feels like? This feels like poor management. Like, someone had some very bad priorities.
I wonder what the sort of, like, what was the development process like?
Yeah.
On a lot of these games? Like, how long did they have to make them? How much stuff did they iterate on before they got to this?
I mean, definitely,
It's like, what I'd normally expect is that the stuff that was done first is the stuff that has lots of animation.
Yeah,
but this
which
was
makes
optional.
Sense.
Like, this is stuff... Well, maybe that's what it is if this is stuff...
Oh,
from
this was added to the Sega CD version, so...
Yeah, so this could be stuff from Ecco 2, where they upped the budget for animation. That could explain it, like, if the turtles are on Ecco 2.
Yeah.
Thing. Ah, there you go, there's the key.
Are you fucking shitting me? They're really difficult to manipulate, it's a problem. Like, okay, so sometimes it doesn't work. I'm not really sure what exactly. Oh, it's not hitting it, it's just bumping into it. I'm so confused as to how this works.
Yeah, it might just be touching it, makes it.
But simply not dashing.
Just hitting it with your sonar.
Oh,
it's going down on.
I don't even
physics understand. Game before physics.
I don't even understand how you would like do that collision detection. That's harder to do.
Damage you? Is it the same rocks?
Plausible.
Invincibility.
Okay, I see. Wait, no, I don't see it. I thought I saw. But I'm actually blind. like the opposite of Amazing Grace. Okay, cool, great.
Maybe you have to have the right invincibility to go through.
Access granted to what? Sure, the access grants things actually do anything.
Yeah, I don't know.
No, no, no.
Shall we EVO and we'll continue
yep.
from the next
yep.
level?
Once more, and then if I drown or killed, we'll stop.
Like, I don't think fundamentally some of these puzzle ideas are bad. I don't know if they belong in this game. But they definitely, like, they could not do the sort of level of physics control that you want to make this world.
Yeah.
Switch over to EVO.
Yep.
It's a shame they can't do a remake with proper physics. Yeah, no, I think like that would be interesting. I'd love to see a version of this done with that game company kind of approach too.
Yeah.
Like, I think that movement really matches with that. Yeah, I could use more gin.
Rose or cherry?
Rose. Oh yeah, we're on a boss fight. Not gonna last long. I think I need to go and get some more evolution points and make myself cooler. Thank you. hear someone whispering in the air above me. Captain, the green crystal has the power to change your body back to the way it was before. Doesn't it? Yes. But Captain, isn't it wrong to operate the process in reverse? This crystal must be bad for the evolution process. Absolutely not. I will not take responsibility for anything that happens. It is still good for the future of this planet.
Lizards. So I think we just need to evolve a bit before we can take on that boss. Oh yeah, the day-night thing. If you can get those insects, I think they're worth more EVO points.
Yeah.
We should have a look at our EVO menu and see what what our options are. I can't remember. I imagine legs. Nice. Jumping dorsal fin tail.
I mean, yeah, yeah,
jump.
Yeah.
I think that's probably what we should go for.
Yeah.
How do I get out of this though?
What was the boss fight like?
It was very short. It involved a lot of jumping, though.
Okay. Do we have the most evolved, like, legs?
We don't seem to have that as an option.
Oh, okay.
So I'm guessing jumping Gorsal is...
Yeah.
Unless this has some sort of, like, bizarre naming convention, I would guess that that makes...
No, that sounds...
someone last time mentioning that this is like the worst form in the game.
I'm definitely saying that, which, you know, makes sense. The stuff that immediately came after things moved to land being awkward, that sounds about right.
It's just like the game's mechanics are fairly simple, so if they're gonna have it get better, there's only so much space to do, and they kind of have to hit the low. It's the problem with RPG mechanics in general.
I definitely feel like if they'd given themselves like a little more room, I don't know what the end game's like.
Yeah,
it's
like,
probably not too fantastical.
Yeah, no, it'll be interesting to see how fast we move, how much we can jump.
I'm just thinking of, what's the shooter that has evolution in it?
Oh, I don't know. We found it in that arcade near Takada no Baba station.
Takada no Baba, yeah. Yeah, no, it's...
Mikado Arcade.
Which is a really good arcade, and I want to go back.
Yeah, if you are ever in Tokyo, that is the arcade to hit.
But yeah, it's, whatever it's called, it's, you know, shooter with evolution, and the stuff you get is really, really weird.
Whoa, what's this?
It's good.
Crazy
it's
magic meat.
Okay, got enough for,
But I'm eating. Gotta keep eating.
Stop eating. Stop eating, it's time for evolution.
Okay. Dorsal fin. Jumping dorsal fin. The wings!
Nice!
Oh yeah, my jump's much higher.
Can you flap them?
My jump's higher and I move faster.
Cool. Do they flap?
They don't seem to. Oh! Christine, I found the best move.
That's not the best move. That's something else.
Whoa, what? How did that... Can I not... Wow, the bounce from that... Was the floating beat a moment ago? Like, flying through the air? Yeah, bouncing on it somehow messes up the, my bounce is so high, it somehow breaks. See what else we might want to up. Whoa, armor body is expensive. Not gonna be touching that for a while. Tail, springtail, thorn tail, thorny springtail. Back of the head. Oh yeah, we've got. Oh yeah, they were all ones that like cost the same amount, so I've got no idea what they do. Jaws, Frog Jaws, Tusken Jaws, Fierce Jaws. Well, let's see if this is enough to take on the enemy. Oh, wait, I can't leave that way. May as well eat my way through this. Some better jaws on the way.
Okay, I can't find the name of that. Turns out that's a really hard thing to go for.
Do you two have copies of the charts the game came with? No, we didn't know that it came with charts.
Oh, yeah.
Do you wanna.
Well, yes.
While I get killed by this thing? It's basically like a weird hopping contest. Oh. This is the worst version of Joust.
Gal, stop getting hopped on.
Hop keeps hopping on me. He said I should be hopping on Pop. They gave letter ranks for what each pup does for things like attack, defense, jump, etc. Yeah, you might be able to find an image of it.
That's what I'm looking for.
Trying to bite him does not seem to be working. I think I need to level up some more. These mechanics will later be distilled in Iron Galaxy's dive kick.
Okay. Wait, no, that doesn't include the one we want.
You want the world when there is land.
Early creatures of land, not Age of Dinosaurs. We are not in the Age of Dinosaurs yet. Okay, so this is.
Oh, I found a better place to hop on things. Listen, you little jerk. I'm trying to eat meat here. Well, I lost a bunch of EVO points for dying. Jumping from getting the.
I assume it stacks.
Okay.
I could be wrong, but I assume so.
What about improving our jaws so that I can just do more damage?
To improve your jaws. You can get fierce jaws. There's also, can I see the evolution screen?
Yeah, give me a second. What do you want to see?
Okay, so Fierce Jaws is what you want.
Okay.
There's just a listing of various things. I'm not sure what these are.
Oh, those are the backs of the head.
Oh.
I can tell you which ones we have. They're cheap. We currently have Moira.
We want Jethro.
What'll that get us?
That'll give you A rank bite.
Oh, awesome.
Jethro gives you, Moira gives you A rank DP. I don't know what that is.
Oh, we've got a much dumber looking head now.
Such is the cost of.
I can deal with that. We're not playing style savvy dinosaurs, sadly, because I would totally play style
that
savvy dinosaurs.
So how much does it cost for the tail? It feels like jumping is like a really useful thing. Oh, we almost have it.
We just want springtail?
Yeah. We don't need Thorny.
What does Thorny get us?
Thorny gives you a better horn, which is useless.
Okay.
And slightly better health. I don't think it's necessary.
What's your chat saying?
They're saying that the ability is stuck.
Goofiest dinosaur proto lizard thing.
Yeah, but we get wicked airtime.
I just always forget to give that a try. we definitely do lose EVO points by dying. Weird things that he can, like, jump on me as we're both in the air, which seems kind of bullshit. Let me... Oh!
Can I give it a try?
Yeah, give it a try. Yeah, we can evolve to up hit points, so we could get what we need and evolve partway through. Yes, this is the problem. He just does that. Maybe you should just keep jumping, like, constantly. Because then, like, yeah. Oh,
yeah.
When you land, you've got a point where you can't jump. Sort of jump and bite him out of the air.
I feel like there's a trick, but I'm just not quite. Like, you can definitely, if you jump.
Yeah, it seems like maybe the trick is to get, like, jump, get out of the, like, as far out of the way as you can.
Oh god, that ass is
yeah.
Brutal.
Oh. He jumps after getting bit, so it's possible to get him stuck in a loop where you just keep biting him as he lands. Why are you taking more damage this time around? 6 hit instead of 4 hit.
It's because we,
one of our things must have changed our armor rating. Should we go back and evolve some more?
Walking might help.
Yeah, the vomit just does so much damage. I feel like they need deliberate decisions in how the physics work to make you need to level up, which is really obnoxious. Okay, I'm gonna level us up a bit more.
do feel like that boss isn't supposed to be hard. It's just, I strongly suspect that the programmers had a better understanding of the physics. Like, that feels like there should be a really easy trick, and we're just not quite hitting it.
Having to deal with them, it's because it's asleep. I feel like the having to eat meat with a button thing is not a great decision.
I feel like this is a recurring theme of eating stuff should just be a natural. Like, it's all you're trying.
Like, it's a finicky interaction versus
being a fun,
interesting interaction. Like, if, like, there's ways you could make, like, if eating was, like, sucking in a bunch of food, if I held this and would suck in all the food nearby, that would be cool. But instead it's like, oh, like, try to position your mouth on the right spot and hit
this
button.
I definitely feel like, I wish an Ecco, like, had a wider range. So, dashing through a school of fish is fun, but turning around to angle yourself just right is not fun.
Yeah, no, if it had giant hitboxes, that might have worked better.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I think I'd still, like, make it auto-pick up, like, there's no reason not to.
Yeah.
Instead, like, have it auto pick up, and it'll just feel inclined to dash through them because that's a fun thing to do.
Yeah. What's your chat up to?
You know, I agree that having the design get more interesting as you go along is not a good way of going about this. So.
That's like,
I think a good way to design this would just be to start out in the age of the dinosaurs. So, like, you start out as some terrifying, super powerful thing, and then you have to become more nimble, and becoming more nimble would make things harder for you. Which I feel like both, you know, works with how life on Earth actually changed, and also more mechanically interesting. I feel like in general, anything that starts easy and or starts hard and becomes easier as you go along is, that's like the opposite. It should never be that way. You should start easy and then get harder. You should start powerful and get weaker.
Well, I think, like, the thing is, like, action RPGs, even if they're based around numbers, partially need to progress the way a Zelda does. It needs to be something where it's like there's more and more options for you to deal with, and those options are actually needed. And so it's the variety of things you need to deal with that offers up the challenge.
That's the thing, like, if you're given more tools because you need to react to a wider variety of challenges, that's interesting. Big boss rush at the end of Link's Awakening, and the whole deal with it is, you know,
damn it, they've got me in a loop. Bunch of little jerks.
You have, like, a ton of really powerful abilities, but the idea is that the boss is, like, constantly changing which items you need to do damage to it.
Yeah.
So, like, they actually turn to a liability. It's a lot easier to fight the earlier bosses because, you know,
you just need to do one thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this, like, it's a combination of two things, and you have a lot of things, so it's a huge possibility space.
So we're updating our jaws, or no, our body. I need to get 5,000.
How much does a horn cost then? Like, what's the cheapest horn?
What is the cheapest horn? Original horn.
Wouldn't be a bad way of chasing it.
Yeah, I just don't know if it'll be enough compared to updating ourselves in more serious ways.
You know what we can do?
Both.
I just dropped a save state.
Okay. So I'll go fight and get a...
Yeah.
Scaly body weight was only 2,000. We're almost there. You know what? Here, let me do this. Let me get a scaly body, and then get 200 won't take that long to wrap up. Oh, for fuck's sakes. Little fucking ninjas. So we figured out what's going on with the meat. It rises to the point your mouth is, even if you're jumping when you get the kill.
Uh-oh. So, trying a little too hard to be helpful?
Yeah. My meats!
Incidentally, the Meat Will Rise is by far my least favorite DJ Shadow album.
Okay, if you want to make a save state now, we'll test this out. Now, someone was pointing out the parallax. It does have, like, a lot of parallax layers. I don't think the art's terribly good, unfortunately. But they do use a lot of parallax layers. Shit, already stuck in a vomit cycle. Yeah, see, like, I got him and then he gets me anyways. Whoa. Give me some horn. Original horn.
Oh,
Looking so good. Yeah, like.
So the thing is, like, if you get above that jump, like, you are okay.
Yeah, but I can't get above that
jump.
Yeah,
it's.
But
well, you can do it, but it's difficult.
Oh, whatever we've changed. Oh, yeah, it's because we changed our stats. Oh. Yeah, it's annoying. If I jump into him, it hurts, but then also there's these bits where if he... Yes, did it! So many meats! We're great! Our proposal to coexist. Now they are attacking our people. The father of this child went to try and persuade them, but he has never returned. Could you please help us? Sure, can I eat you also?
Miguel!
Child, if they ever show up again. Ancestor of cockroach. Ah!
Miguel, they're roaches!
Oh my god, they're worth so many EVO points.
That seems unlikely.
Riveting gameplay here, folks.
Just let the roaches waddle into your mouth. On a Super Nintendo.
Really like the song I couldn't hear what the music was. Oh!
Miguel, that...
Yeah. That's right, I can hop on insects.
Sky meat.
Sorry, I missed the sky meat. Yeah, got it. We get that 5,000 so we can up our... Yeah, an ether was like a suck-in would be so much better. Jump is making it harder to eat sky meat.
Yeah.
Oh, the kids give you negative hit points? I didn't notice they're negative. I now want to check that that's the case.
As a peacemaker.
Wait, if that's the queen bee's stinger, is she
don't
dead?
Even worry about it.
Sorry, king bee.
Wait. I mean, that would explain why it.
Whoa! could go back, grind a bit, and get that really good body. Also, apparently, you can eat bones like a hyena. You're not being a pain if you recommend upgrading jaws. What do we need to do to upgrade our jaws, anyways? We might already be at the place.
Yeah,
let's do that then, and we'll go and see what the boss is like. Oh, that's interesting. The jaws, the amount of damage changes the knockback.
Yeah, that's... seems helpful.
Yeah, it's a bit harder, actually.
I was just saying, like, when there's two on top of each other.
Yeah. Else we can update that's small before we do this?
I think it's pretty much just... yeah, it's just done. I'd say keep going.
Keep leveling up? And get the body?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
I mean, we should use up... most of our points, because...
we'll die and we'll lose a bunch of them. What?
Is it with one sky?
I don't know.
Well, it's one sky.
Yeah, this is true. No, sky meat is worth the same as regular meat. Interesting, at night they come both ways. There.
that.
As long as the style is some sort of weird glam metal lizard. I like that they're just trying to get away from us. Like, have you seen...
Oh, are they larva?
Yeah. Of that one, they will eventually attempt to attack.
I like our attack. I think we're just falling into them.
How bees work.
How any life on Earth works.
Now is when you worry about scientific sacrificial accuracy. Scientific accuracy? Not when Earth is pretty lady with blue hair. No, we've already decided the cosmology in this is batshit crazy.
Did you say totally accurate?
Yes, I did.
Totally accurate.
I used the other word for total accurate. Whoa.
I'm having a bad time. Go.
We don't have enough,
We don't have enough for horn.
Yeah, we have to do a bit of grinding if we want some horns to switch back and forth. If you can get it into the cycle where you're just biting it a bunch and keeping it low,
yeah,
that does pretty well. Okay, I love that they didn't tone that sprite at all when it goes up.
That's so brutal.
Yeah, going after food's not worth it.
You can
like,
you can really stun lock it.
You need to really, you need to stun lock the bee. Do not let the bee stun lock you. As a great teacher once said. don't understand why the bee doesn't see how fucking stylish we are. Be sure to use your chomp on them a lot, but that does a lot more damage than your bats. Yeah. And it brings it down so you can actually get it. Yeah. There's like definitely a pattern you could work on this, but as soon as you break the
fuck,
it just fucks you up. Let me give it another shot.
Yeah, sure.
Hi, nice off lady.
Like, I can't believe all of those things can hit.
It definitely has a certain amount of the, like, what I consider, like, bad action RPG design.
Yeah.
Like, the difference between Secrets of Mana and Second Episode 2-3, where one of them actually has really good combat, the other one looks beautiful but has, like, garbage combat. It's more based around stats than it is around skill. Holy shit!
Yeah, it's...
I think they assume you can dash on... Yeah, the dashing is not easy.
I feel like it's not that hard, but...
I don't know, compared to, like, I've been playing a bunch of, Wonder Boy 4... Or Monster World 4. Monster Land? Monster World
4. Monster World 4.
And in that I was mistakenly dashing a few times during bosses. What?
Like, you can just get hit by a stair.
Yeah. Maybe you should evolve some invincibility frames.
That was one of the greatest innovations in life on Earth, was... Gonna be honest, Gaia, I think we're a pretty shitty boyfriend. I'm ready to just, like, hop back into the water now. We had a good thing going on there.
Yeah, can we turn into a fish that's maybe immune to these things? Oh my god, and a slightly seeking, like...
Yeah.
Oh. This bee's got no chill. We do have the stun lock strategy.
We're
right?
Just
yeah.
Not actually quite getting it.
Like, part of the problem is that it's only your mouth that does the jaw damage, so if you go a little bit too far in before hitting the button, you end up, like, chewing behind its back.
I wonder if we can, like, do that instead.
Yeah, the problem with that is that it's slow. I'm not sure what the damage frame. Oh, for fuck's sakes!
Well.
Here, I can charge you to death just as good as you. It's amazing how much more interesting things are both when the enemies and you have invincibility frames.
Yeah.
Like, again, playing a bunch of, Monster World, that's a big part of it, both for you and for the enemies. Like, how
yeah.
You wait for their invincibility frames to leave.
Yeah, that was always the big thing in Mega Man. You know, you have, like, weapons that do extra damage, but, you know, they're invincibility frames, so it turns into... You know, they have patterns, but you also have to build your own patterns. I feel like that is the implication.
What's really interesting, if we ever do Secrets of Mana, is Secrets of Mana also has... hit down that does no damage, so you can end up in a situation where you're still keeping an enemy down, but you're doing no damage to it. And then it comes up, has a moment of invincibility, and then you can hit it, which works really well with the multiplayer.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that's...
So you sort of have people who are just doing control, who are just keeping enemies down, but not doing damage, while other people are getting the big attack ready. And then they fucked it all up the second episode, C3. No, what? Not allowed.
I don't know what you expected.
I thought I wasn't there yet.
You expected this to be fair?
Yeah, so the problem is that you can pass right through it and chew behind it. Run and eat all his babies. We can't eat fast enough.
While satisfying, I'm not sure it's actually helpful. Man, those things do so much damage, even though we're at like.
Yeah, that's the thing. We aren't exactly like a weak character
at
this point. Spoiler, this is the easier of the bees. Oh, Jesus.
Fuck.
Oh, shit, it's out of the way, just like, perfect. Anything else we can grind up at this point, right?
I mean, we could do horn strategy.
Yeah. But it'd be so easy to lose all of that by just getting stun locked.
Extremely easy. But I think it still gives us more of a chance.
Yeah. Yeah, all bosses are vulnerable to evolution spam if you need it.
I think we need it.
Oh, we can still get the best tail for 1,000. What does that get us?
It gives us a little more hit points.
And more strength.
That's just
but yeah. And more agility and more jumping ability.
Oh, no, we've already got.
Yeah, you'd be trading those off, yeah.
It's A rank no matter what.
It's just a combination of the other two. Just remember to spam EVOs the first time because losing half your EP every time snowballs to make it harder. Yeah. We just loaded a save state back.
That was not a very smart. Hang on.
We're gonna put rewind as a button.
Let's see if we can rewind past. No, we might be fucked. Okay. We will
defeat Jumpy McAsshole again.
I think we'll probably cheat our way through that.
Yeah.
I think that's a reasonable thing to do.
And they never play EVO again. Table flip.
Blew it.
Evolve table flip. So yeah, we've got, it looks like still some more EVO and still some more, and of course more Seaman.
Unfortunately,
he's kind of a lovable little scamp.
Uh-huh.
Look, we're running out of things that can have faces in that game, so it's not going to be too bad. All this time traveling does really break my heart. Mysterious time stream devolves you.
It's fine. We'll sort it out. It's cool. My girlfriend's Gaia. We can work this out.
So this is EVO Chapter 2 of 5. And it looks like we're only... Is the second half of the island a different chapter, or is it the same chapter?
I think it's... let's find out. Let's look at the manual. Yeah, it's just the second chapter. Oof. So maybe we'll...
Don't say that, they'll find new things to put faces on. I think I know what we're doing, final stream of Seaman. Gotta find some friends with us for the 3D printer.
That's upsetting. Okay. Let's sign off before you get any more ideas.
It's a really good idea, trust me.
Okay, you're wrong.
But yeah, we should be, are you going to be too busy with launch stuff next week?
We'll find out. It's extremely plausible. My game's coming out in 2 weeks, so...
You can do it.
I sure hope so.
Hang in there. Evo the grind for Eden. I think Seaman definitely needs... I don't know why they never made plushies.
That's fucked up. Anyway, I think that's about it.
Yeah, that's it. We'll maybe be here next week.
Maybe
otherwise,
next
we'll
week.
Be like the week after, unless you're also in crazy land.
Yeah, we'll see.
But after that, neither of us have anything coming out too soon, so...
Yeah.
It should
definitely
be a little bit easier to keep it
month.
Regular. So, until next time, thanks everyone.
Thanks for joining.